This is Heddal Stave Church. Once Norway was filled with stave churches, there were around 3,000 stave churches in the 12th century in Norway. Today, only 28 churches remain, and this one is the biggest of them all. The oldest part of the church, the chancellerat, was built in 1147, and it was later extended in 1242 to the size that we know today. A major restoration took place in the 19th century, between 1849 and 1851, and it was later restored in the 1960s. One of the processes that is used to restore these stave churches is to cover them in tar to preserve the wood and to make them more resistant to fire. Many wooden buildings in Norway were burnt down through the ages. That is why there are so few of them left today. This was a pilgrimage site for a long time, and it was the main spiritual gathering place for the people of this region. Why are these called stave churches? Because of the method that was used to build them, called post and beam, which is a placement of wooden boards vertically, which constitute the main foundation of the church. That's why these are called stave churches, because those boards were also called staves. These churches were built at a time where Christianity just arrived in Norway. So the craftsmen that built these places actually had craftsmen building skills from the Vikings. That is why they sort of merged the two worlds together. Not only from the way they were built, but also from the kind of decoration they have, because they have lots of pagan patterns and details. We are at the province of Telemark in southern Norway, and the ticket to visit Heddal Stave Church, which closes at 6 p.m. in the summertime, as of 2015, it costs 80 Norwegian crowns and includes a visit to a museum nearby. It's really worth visiting this place.